held by an owner or by the lessee under a finance lease, okay, to earn rentals or for capital appreciation or both. So anong purpose? Ba't ka may investment property? The intention is, okay, the asset or the property is being held for rental to others, ano pa? For capital appreciation or both. Okay, so tas tingnan mo, ano lang ang pwede maging investment property? Land and building. So kung meron mang albaw, may equipment, machinery, di ba, na held for rentals to others, anong gagawin lang doon? Automatic PPE po yun. Di ba? Kasi ang pwede lang na investment property, land and building. Gets po ba? Okay, isa pang ano dito, kapag yung mga investment property under construction, pero sure ka na, nagagamitin mo siya as investment property, okay, anong classification nun? Investment property. O dati kasi, dapat ano siya, PPE. Okay, tapos pagkatapos na, tapos sure ka na talaga na investment property, o doon pa lang siya magiging investment property. Nakuha, o, pero ang concept, ano na, basta sure ka, kahit na during construction pa lang, investment property na yan. Gets na? Gets yun? Okay, next po. Another possible na magkaroon ng confusion dun sa classification ng investment property. Okay, what if portion of the property is being used as PPE and then yung portion, investment property? Okay, so ang term niya sa PPE dito sa standard is owner-occupied. Pero PPE lang yun. Eh? Okay, so sabi niya, if portion is being used as owner-occupied and another portion is being used as investment property, you need to separately account for that for the portions, di ba? Okay, kung kaya mong i-segregate yung ano yung portion, you can specifically identify kung ano yung portion na ginagamit as owner-occupied, i-account mo siya as owner-occupied. Kung ano yung portion na ginagamit as investment property, i-account mo siya as investment property. Nagigets yun? And what if it is impractical? Sabi niya, what if impractical na i-segregate yung portion na owner-occupied, yung portion na investment property? O, anong sabi, anong interpretation po ni standard? Sabi niya, okay, titignan mo kung paano siya significantly used. If it is significantly used as investment property, tapos impractical na ihiwalay yung owner-occupied, the entire property will be treated as investment property. Okay? If it is significantly used as owner-occupied, then the entire property will be classified as owner-occupied. Nagets mo na? Okay. Kaya yon? Yes? O, next. Isa pa. Okay. Tapos, isa pa pong indicator dyan na pwede natin gamitin would be yung ancillary services na pwede provide. Parang additional services in maintaining the property. Kung basic lang na repairs and maintenance, security services lang yan, or yun yung ang term niya is insignificant ancillary services, yun, anong treatment mo? Investment property. Pero kung ang yung ancillary services being provided by the entity is significant, okay, or significant, ayun, itreat mo siya as owner-occupied. Tapos ang example na binigay was a hotel. Diba? Yung hotel, diba, lahat ng gagawin dun sa property o na day-to-day basis, diba? Sinong nagmamanage talaga? Yung entity. So yun, ang treatment niya dyan ay PPE, owner-occupied. Gets po ba? Nasusundan mo yun? Okay. Next po, ang isa pang basic characteristic po ng investment property, dapat investment siya. O paano pagka-investment? Ano po ang basic characteristic ng investment? The activity shall generate cash flows, okay, that are independent from, okay, from the regular assets or dun sa normal operations. Para masabi mong investing activity siya. Kasi, di ba pagka arising from regular operations, operating lang yon. Nakuha mo siya? Okay, so dapat para maging investments, okay, para maging investment yung property na yan, dapat it could generate independently from other assets of the entity. Gets? Okay, kaya tignan mo, ano ang magiging potential na problema? Tignan mo to, ha? Halimbawa po, leasing company. Leasing company siya. So, yung leasing company, anong normal niyang negosyo? Magpaupa. Di ba? Naniniwala ba kayo sa akin? Na ang leasing company, nagpapaupa? Sige, yes. Di ba? So, ayun. Ang normal na negosyo niya, magpapaupa. Eh, meron siyang land and building na pinapaupa. Okay? Eh, anong, di ba? Parang pasok yun as investment property. O, anong magiging presentation niya? Sa totoo lang, as of the moment, gray area siya. Okay? Even sa practice, kahit po sa practice, okay, kahit sa practice, pwede siyang i-present as investment property, pwede siyang i-present as PPE. Oh, hindi siya ganun ka. Kasi nonetheless, non-current asset pa rin naman. Nagets mo yan? Oh, yun nga lang, pagka susundan mo technically, anong mas appropriate? PPE. Kasi yun yung regular activity niya. Nagets mo? Oh, so if ever, pagka yung talagang pag-deciding ka, di ba, kung ano magiging treatment, oh, mas appropriate na mag-PPE ka ba? Gets po ba? Next po. Ano pa? Oh, basic definition or recognition, yung basic asset recognition principle natin, probable that future economic benefits will flow to the entity and the cost can be measured reliably. Okay na? So, pwede ka na mag-recognize ng investment property. O, measurement. O, ito. Measurement. Paano po ang measurement ng investment property? Measurement. So, sa measurement, initial, parang PPE lang to, it shall be recognized at cost. And actually, yung cost, yung capitalizable cost dito, okay, kung ano yung kinakapitalize natin sa PPE, yun lang rin yun. Nasusundan yan. So, later, makikita natin kung ano yung, parang after investment, diba, PPE na. Okay, makikita na natin kung ano yung mga, o paano mag-capitalize sa PPE. So, yun rin yung concepts na gagamitin mo dito. So, doon na lang natin pag-usapan. Tapos, hindi rin naman natin kakailanganin initially dun sa mga problems natin. Okay? And then, aside from that, okay, after right, initially recognizing it, paano naman po ang magiging subsequent measurement niya? Okay? So, eto, may option si entity to choose between cost model at saka, ano po? Cost model and fair value model. Cost model and fair value model. O, yun lang. Di ba, parang PPE lang rin. Ang PPE, ano siya, cost model at saka revalued amount naman. Dito, cost model at saka fair value. Okay, so paano po ginagawa ang cost model? Kung paano ang PPE? Cost, tas i-depreciate mo siya. Cost, less accumulated depreciation, less accumulated impairment losses. Nasusundan yun? Okay, next. O, paano naman ang fair value model? Ang fair value model, di ba, initially re-recognize at cost, okay, tas i-re-measure at fair value, tas any difference between the latest fair value at saka yung recorded amount or yung carrying amount, saan lang papasok? P&L. Okay, tas wala na siyang ano, wala siyang depreciation. Kasi nga, yung fluctuation na ng fair value, yung nagiging basis. Nagigets yan? Okay, okay, isa pang major difference ng investment property at PPE. Sa PPE po, ano, ito yung mas alam mo kasi, no? Sa PPE, di ba, the entity shall choose between cost model and revalued amount model, and then it shall apply the selected policy or the selected measurement basis will be applied to the entire class of PPE. So, halimbawa, yung lupa mo, lahat ng yung lupa, minesure mo at cost model, dapat lahat ng lupa naka-cost model. Yung isang building mo, minesure mo at revalued amount model, lahat ng building dapat naka-revalued amount model. So, ganun yung applicability na. Entire class lang. Okay. Sa investment property po, hindi ganon. Okay? Mamimili ka between cost and fair value model. And then, you should apply the selected measurement basis to all investment properties. Nakuha siya? So, kung nag-decide ka na fair value yung isang lupa, dapat lahat ng investment property mo, land and building man yan, dapat naka-fair value model. Gets na? Nasundan yun? O, kaya lang may konting may dalawang in-specify na exemptions. Okay, paano yung dalawang in-specify na exceptions? Kunyari, may 10 tayong investment properties. Tapos, we opted to use fair value model. Okay, yun nga lang, one of the investment properties has no available fair value. So, yung siyang may fair value. I-measure mo to at fair value. And then, yung isa, dahil walang fair value, i-cost mo siya. O, diba? So, hindi lahat naka-fair value. Pero, dahil kaya hindi mo siya minesure at fair value, kasi wala lang fair value. Once na maging available ang fair value, okay, dapat i-fair value mo na siya. Nagets mo yung exception? Okay, if one of the items, okay, if one of the items lacks fair value, then i-measure mo siya at cost, di ba? Tapos naka-fair value pa rin yung iba. Nasusundan mo yun? Okay, next, ano pa? Okay, if the investment property is backing liabilities, paano po yun? Halimbawa, may 10 tayong investment property. 6 not backing liabilities. Hindi sila nagsiserve as collateral. Backing. Ayan. So, tapos yung 4, ginagamit siya as collateral for a certain liability. Okay? Or they are backing liabilities. Gets na? Okay, sabi niya, yung backing liabilities, may option ka. I-fair value model mo yan or i-cost model mo. Tapos yung not backing liabilities, ganun din. I-fair value model mo or i-cost model mo. So, pwedeng mag-decide si entity dun sa not backing liabilities ko naka-cost model. Dun sa backing liabilities ko naka-fair value model. That would be allowed. Gets mo? Nasundan siya. So, pero as a general rule, okay, all investment properties shall be initially as shall be subsequently measured either okay, using cost model or using fair value model. Nakuha? Gets yun? Okay. So, paano po ginagawa yan? Say, illustrate natin. Eto. Problem number one. O, 1, 2, 3, yan yung mga investment properties. Ano? Okay, number one. A parent and its subsidiaries provided the following properties owned by the group. O, hinihingi sa atin in the consolidated statement of financial position of the parent and its subsidiaries, what total amount should be reported as investment property. And then sa pangalawa, what total amount should be included in property, plant, and equipment in the consolidated statement of financial position of parent and its subsidiaries. So, land held for undetermined future use. Anong treatment? Investment property. Diba? Investment property. Okay, so, ayun. Kasi for capital appreciation, yung magiging presumption dyan. Okay? O, next. Vacant building to be leased out under an operating lease. O, ipapaupa? Held for rentals? Yes. Building ba yan? Yes. So, investment property. Property held for use in production. Anong treatment? PPE. O, note na natin ha, PPE. Next po, property held by a subsidiary, real estate firm in the ordinary course of business. So, ano to? Inventory. Diba? Ibebenta niya yan. Next po, building owned by subsidiary and the subsidiary provides security and maintenance services to the lessees. So, ano lang siya? Significant, insignificant? Insignificant. So, anong treatment? Investment property. Okay na? So, example po yan ng insignificant ancillary services. Investment property. Land leased to a subsidiary under an operating lease. So, yung lupa, pinapaupa. Kanino daw? Kay subsidiary. So, anong treatment? Investment property o PPE? Answer, o, di ba? Sa consolidated, yung parent and subsidiary will be treated as single economic entity. So, pinapaupa niya sa sarili niya. In short, siya yung gumagamit. So, sa consolidated consolidated FS perspective, si entity yung gumagamit. So, ano to? PPE. Pero kung individual FS ni parent company, investment property na yan. Nagets ma? Okay, so, eh, kaya lang, ang hinihingi sa atin, also. So, anong treatment mo dito? PPE. Okay? O, take note ha. If individual FS, investment property yan. Okay? Next. Equipment leased to an unrelated party under an operating lease. Pinapaupa? Yes. Anong treatment? O, PPE kasi equipment. Diba? Ang pwede lang na investment property, land and building. O, building under construction for use as investment property. O, sure na siya. Nagagamitin na si investment property. So, anong treatment? Investment property. Okay na? Okay na, okay na? Yes. So, anong mga investment property mo? Yung 1 million plus 2 million plus 2.5 yung may ancillary services at saka 3.5 diba, na building under construction. So, magkano ang sagot? Magkano? 9 million. Okay. So, letter D, delta. Nakuha yun? O, next. O, PPE. Anong mga PPE natin? Yung 4 million. Tapos, yung list, land lease to a subsidiary na 1.5. Diba? PPE yan. At saka yung equipment na 500. Nasusundan? So, 4 million plus 1.5 plus 500. Pagkano yun? 6 million. And then, yung 3 million, inventory. Diba? So, answer po for number 1 is Delta. Number 2 is Charlie. Okay. Next. Number 2, what is the gain to be recognized for 2020? So, pag, regarding the disposal of the property, o, yung gain or loss dito, simple lang, di ba? Selling price, or net proceeds from disposal, less carrying amount, di ba? So, ayun, so tingnan natin. An entity purchased an investment property on January 1, 2019 at a cost of 4 million. The property had a useful life of 20 years and on December 31, 2020, had a fair value of 4.8. On December 31, 2020, the property was sold for net proceeds of 4.5. So, magkano daw ang selling price, net selling price? 4.5 million. 4.5 million. So, saan mo lang ko compare? Carrying amount. So, anong carrying amount yan? Depende kung anong model lang ginagamit, di ba? Okay. So, the entity used the cost model to account for investment property. So, ano lang gagawin natin? Magkano po ang carrying amount nito? So, i-depreciate mo lang, di ba? 4 million, okay, divided by ilang taon daw niya ina-expect na gagamitin. Walang method na sinabi. So, presumption, straight line. Wala rin naman residual value, di ba? So, 4 million divided by 20, tapos oh, multiply na lang natin nung ano, remaining life, di ba? So, ilang taon na gamit? 2 years, 2019-2020. Okay, so meron pang natitirang 18 years. Nakuha yun. So, 4 million divided by 20 times 18, magkano po yan? 3.6. Oh, masaya, malungkot? Yung 3.6, nabenta mo ng 4.5. Okay, masaya by how much? 900,000. Okay yun? Okay, so 900,000. Next. Oh, problem number 3. So, number 2, it's alpha. Number 3, on January 1, 2019, an entity acquired 3 investment properties. So, ayan, initial cost, tas may fair values. Tingnan natin, so anong gamit, ano? So, each property had an estimated useful life of 10 years. The accounting policy is to use fair value model for investment properties. So, naka-fair value model, no? So, what is the gain or loss to be recognized for the year ended December 31, 2020? Okay, so for 2019, gain or loss, magkano po ang total cost? 2.7 plus 3.450 plus 3.3, magkano yun? 9,450,000, tama? 9,450, yes. O, tapos magkano ang fair value ng December 31, 2019? 3.2 plus 3 million plus 3.9, magkano na? Magkano? 10.1. 10.1. So, base, oh, for 2019, gain or loss? Yung 9,450 naging 10.1. Gain or loss? Gain. So, magkano gain? 650,000. So, debit, investment property, 650. Credit, gain. Okay, gain from changes in fair value, okay, 650. Saan papasok yun? P&L. Gets? Gets na? Okay. Next po, so magkano running balance ng investment property natin? December 31, 2019, 10.1. O at December 31, 2020, magkano na po ang fair value? 4 million plus 2.1 plus 3.6. Magkano na lang? 9.7. Okay, tama? 9.7? Okay, so 9.7. Masaya, malungkot? O, malungkot, di ba? Yung dati mong 10.1, 9.7 na lang. So magkano po yung naging decline? 400,000. Okay, so 400,000 loss. Debit loss or changes in fair value, credit, investment property, 400,000. So yung letter C, yan yung pang 2019 sana. Eh, ang hinihingi 2020, di ba? So ang sagot po natin is letter B. Bravo. 400,000 loss. Did you get that? Nasundan po ba? Okay. Next po. Problem number 4. Ito mga funds, di ba? So, sa mga funds, yung sa classification, naaral na natin to when we discussed yung cash and cash equivalents. Di ba, may mga inaral tayo, mga ikli na classify natin doon as non-current asset. Halimbawa, basic siguro, sinking fund. Di ba, sinking fund, non-current asset po ba yan? Non-current, o generally, di ba, pero it should parallel the classification of the related liability. Kung ang liability ay non-current, non-current din yung funds. Kung ang liability ay current, current asset yung fund. Nagets mo yan? Okay, next. Ano pa? Yung mga preference redemption fund, yung pambayad ng preference shares. Ano pa po? Fund to acquire an item of PPE, you know, for plant expansion. Nasusundan mo yun? Insurance fund, contingency fund, di ba? Yun yung mga for non-current purposes. Yan yung i-classify natin as okay, non-current asset. Okay na? So, ayun. So, Ito, yung proper measurement lang. So, proper measurement lang nun would be kung magkano yung totoong value niya. Di ba? Yung appropriate value niya. Okay? So, ayun. So, ito yung illustration natin, parang iniingi lang naman sa atin, magkano yung dapat na i-deposito niya para makaipon siya ng certain amount. So, yan ang may mga common common problems dyan. Ano? Okay, tapos kung if ever, halimbawa, tanungin ka ng proper measurement basis, tignan mo lang kung magkano yung appropriate value ng fund itself. Okay? So, tignan mo kung may mga, kasi minsan may fund na iahalo dyan yung mga measured at fair value. I-measure mo at fair value. May mga fund na dapat nakabase sa present value of cash flows, i-measure mo siya at present value of cash flows. Nakukuha yun? O, eto, i-address natin to. So, tingnan natin yung problem number 4. Anong hinihingi sa problem number 4? Sa problem number 4, what is the annual deposit to the fund? Okay, so on January 1, 2019, an entity adopted a plan to accumulate funds for a new building to be erected beginning January 1, 2023 at an estimated cost of 20 million. So gusto niyang makaipon ng magkano? 20 million. Okay, so starting, kasi kailangan yon ng January 1, 2023 to construct a building. Okay, so the entity intends to make 4 equal annual deposits in a fund beginning December 31, 2019. So anong araw ngayon? January 1, 2019, kailan ang first payment? December 31, 2019. So, if ever, anong gagamitin mong present value factor or future value factor? Ordinary annuity. O, same concept pa rin, ha? O, eto lang, futuristic lang tayo. Kukunin mo lang yung future value, di ba? So, kasi ang future value, ganito yung calculation niya. Future value of the funds will be calculated by multiplying kung magkano yung annual payments, o dito, in this case, annual deposit yung ginamit, multiplied by future value factor. Diba? Ganun lang yan. Okay, so ang gusto niyang mangyari, makaipon ng 20 million. Tapos ang inihingi, magkano yan. Diba? So, ayun. So, that will earn interest at 12% compounded annually. The future value of an ordinary annuity of 1 at 12% for 4 periods is 4.78. And then, the future value of an annuity of 1 in advance at 12% for 4 periods is 5.35. So, anong gagamitin natin? Kasi magbabayad siya sa end ng period. So, ano to? Ordinary annuity. So, gamitin natin times 4.78. Diba? O, times 4.78. O, kaya mo na bang makompute yung annual deposit? Yes. Diba? So, magkano ang annual deposit natin? Annual deposit would be equal to 20 million divided by 4.78, or that would be equal to magkano ba? 4,184,100. So basta dapat alam mo lang kung ano yung appropriate future value factor na gagamitin mo, di ba? Nasundan po ba yan? Kaya to, kaya? Yes. Okay, so siguro mas maganda try natin ulit paano mag-compute ng future values. Diba? Kasi sanay tayo sa present value, right? O, future value of 1, o, ito pinakamadali, di ba? Future value of 1 would be 1 plus I raised to positive N. Okay? Future value of ordinary annuity, paano? 1 plus I raised to positive N minus 1 divided by I. Okay? Di ba parang sa atin, sa present value, negative N ito, tas 1 minus answer. So, yun lang, ganun lang, no? O, gusto mo try dun para mapalabas mo yung 4.78, diba? And then, pagka future value of annuity due, copyin mo na lang to, 1 plus I raised to positive N minus 1 divided by I. Tapos, huwag mo na lang kalimutan na ano, i-multiply ng 1 plus I. Gets po ba? So, same lang sila nung ordinary annuity. Tapos, minultiply lang natin ng 1 plus I to consider yung early payment. Gets yan? Nakuha, nakuha. Yes. Okay, so para sure lang na lahat na-expose tayo, di ba? Okay, so yan po yung ating problem number 4. So the correct answer would be bravo. Okay? Next, so dun sa classification nun, yung concept na ginamit natin sa cash. Ha? O, sige po, let's have our short break, tapos ituloy natin yung accounting for cash surrender value. Then we'll be answering quizzes, theoretical concept quizzes. Tapos tingnan natin kung abutan pa natin. Okay? Sige.